Biff's Gaming Videos. Joysticks and joypads.
Trackballs and mouse pads.
Swimmers and my guns.
Fun.
Alien invasions.
Robotic invasions.
Dungeons and dragons.
Fun.
Home runs and touchdowns.
Jungles and ghost towns.
Videos from Biff Sun.
Fun.
This is Asteroids for the Atari 5200 Super System. It was one of the four launch titles that came out for the 5200. Wait a second, did I say a launch title? Well, if you take a look at the numbering, it's actually the first title that Atari had planned to release. And, Asteroids was Atari's biggest selling arcade game ever. You know, it was a great game. It made Atari into this arcade behemoth at the time. And, they had all these hit titles, and this was the biggest of them all. But it never really came out. But the game is finished. You know what? It never came out. It's actually a working prototype. If you take a look at this version, you'll notice that it differs from the arcade in several ways. First is that you have shields, so sometimes when the guy goes to a ball, like right there, that's shields. That was really an Asteroids Deluxe game, because they had Asteroids Deluxe, Space Duel, Blastoids, a whole ton of sequels in the arcades. And so they implemented that. Another thing they implemented was multiplayer version, where you could have more than one ship on the screen at one time. If you take a look at it, the graphics look kind of crappy. They don't even look like the 2600 version, which the 2600 version was actually pretty decent. When that thing came out, everybody had that, everybody played it, and it was actually a very, very good home version, because it was a raster version of the Vector game, so it was a very, very good version. This just looks cheesy. The little UFOs look cheesy, the Asteroids look cheesy, and you know what? Controlling the ship is kind of tough to do. It's not like impossible. In the 2600, you can control it pretty well. But in the 5200, it's almost impossible to play this game effectively. You know, you get used to it after a while. But I think maybe that's the reason why Atari decided not to release this game. Because if the controls are really bad, and it looks really bad, the graphics are horrible, then no one's going to buy it. They're going to say, oh, why am I buying this when the 2600 version was better? Now, there are some hacks to this game. Someone released a hack that made it more like the Vector graphics look, so you can get that ROM and download it and play it, which is kind of cool. You know, I mean, anybody that makes a homebrew or a hack of one of the games is always welcome. So it gives it more of a better graphics feel, more like the arcade, but it doesn't really change, the play. You basically sit there and just fire in all the directions. The 2600 version was on a different joystick, so it played better. So the problem with this is that the gameplay just is horrible, and the graphics is horrible. There's really nothing to like about this game. It's just a bad game. It's a horrible game. And that's probably the reason why it never came out, even though it was the first game listed for the system. It's in catalogs. It was supposed to be a release title, and its entire lifespan, it never came out. Now, if you ask a lot of old school guys, they're going to say Asteroids is their favorite game. You know, some people might say Donkey Kong or Pac-Man or Miss Pac-Man. But you know what? The guys that are a little older actually liked Asteroids. They liked the version of 2600. They liked to play it on MAME and so forth. But this particular version is a prototype. You can just stay away from it. It sucks. I'm giving this game a D+, and the only reason I don't give it a D- is because it is Asteroids. There was another game that came out from another company that was a ripoff of Asteroids that you can check out for the 5200 as well, but this particular version from Atari, home product from Atari, D+.